Hey, hi everybody, how you doing? Listen, go and have a cup of tea. We're going to be ready in about 5 minutes. Come back, be here, 5 minutes time. Starting now! Welcome to the O2.
It's going
to
be a hot, hot summer of rock and roll. Paul McCartney is tearing up venues in America and the UK with 10 live shows on his all-new up-and-coming tour. It's the hottest ticket of the year. Macca's brought his magic to London's O2 Arena to rehearse for the gigs, packing in more than 2 hours of the greatest back catalogue in music. He and his crew also bring stadium-sized production values. 31 trucks are needed to transport the gear. At this rehearsal, the whole crew nail each part of the show. The lights, the staging, the band's final preparations, and the spectacular visuals.
That's not bad.
Mac is involved in every aspect, but why are the world's greatest rock star and his tour up and coming?
Well, you know, I mean, I'm an up and coming artist. So, you know, I thought, that works. And the tour is up and it's coming, and it's up and coming tour. I don't know, we were just goofing around. We were going to call it Coming Up Tour and stuff. And I just thought, well, up and coming.
Mac is the most successful songwriter in pop history, and his sellout Good Evening Europe tour last year got rave reviews. The incredibly hard-working former Beatles up and coming shows will showcase the best work in a five-decade career.
I just love it, you know. I love to do it. So when I've got a concert coming up or rehearsal like this, yeah, I really look forward to it. It's like, oh, yeah, great. I see the band. Get to plug in electric guitar, bass, piano. It's what I love.
Macca's incredible, energetic show ends with a run in the UK and Ireland. He's rocking the Isle of Wight Festival, his first ever standalone stadium show in Glasgow, his first show in Wales for 36 years at the Millennium Stadium, and finally the amazing Hard Rock Calling Festival in Hyde Park. Coming tour also takes Sir Paul back to the Hollywood Bowl, where Beatlemania was at its peak 46 years ago.
When we go to America, in all these gigs, it's only 10 gigs. So, you know, a lot of people go out for 3 months, and that's a bit more, you know, challenging. And it's easier to get fed up on that kind of tour. But we've taken the last year or so to just doing kind of one-offs, going to a place, and then not playing the next door town the next night. So it actually makes, it keeps you hungry. You're like, oh, where are we going next, you know?
A little midnight special, shine a silver love light on me.
Macca's reuniting his brilliant band, Rusty Anderson, Brian Ray, Paul Wicks Wickens, and Abe Laboriel Jr., to give a stadium rock feel to timeless tracks loved by fans of all ages. Imagine 40,000 voices singing this.
We've been playing together quite a long time now. It's coming up for 10 years. So whether you like it or not, you become a band. You feed off each other and you read each other. So that's nice when that kicks in. And then when you get back together again, you go, oh, didn't sound bad this, you know. So it makes the whole thing quite exciting and fresh.
Macca will be rocking Beatles and Wings hits, plus beautiful solo gems like this Golden Globe-nominated track from the Robert De Niro movie Everybody's Fine. It's just one of the rare treats in store, and it's never been played live in the US.
Oh,
Yeah, we're doing a few songs that we've never done before. Some that we have done before, but we haven't done for a long time. So just bringing some back. One or two that we've never done before.
So the up-and-coming shows will feature an expertly balanced set from the ultimate pro, the sort that made his headline set at Glastonbury Festival in the UK 6 years ago legendary. Fans in Puerto Rico will get their first ever chance to experience it.
Out of 20, 40,000 people, there's a lot of people there who've had to save to come to this concert. So we try and give them the best night out of their lives.
It's going to be the concert experience of a lifetime. Britain's greatest living musician on the up-and-coming tour this summer.
Hey, here we are. Are you ready to start? Yeah, okay, so am I. Well, welcome everyone all around the world. We're getting messages coming in fast and furious here. So thank you. Thank you very much for taking part in this live thingy cast. So let's go. First of all, we got here. We in Mexico are so happy of having Paul again. Well, I am so happy of being in your country soon. Amigos, in Mexico, I salute you. Saludos. All right, that's great. So then we have that was from Gravis Records MX via Twitter. Now we have from Cadelm via Ustream. Come to Brazil, Paul. Come to Brazil. No, you come here, please, in my little room. Yeah, I'll come to Brazil. I love Brazil. And thank you very much for sending that. Okay, now this is from Annie Lavoie. Hey, Annie. How you doing out there? You all right? Good. This says, what song you wrote do you enjoy to play live the most and why? You know, that's always a difficult question. It kind of depends on my mood, in truth. Sometimes you really fancy doing the rock and roll stuff, you know, so something like Paperback Writer is something I'm enjoying at the moment. Obladi Oblada is great for audience sing-along. I'm enjoying doing that. And then on the other hand, it might be something like Day in the Life or something like that, which I like. Something, both tributes to John and George. I think the thing is just come along to a show and see which one you like. Never mind me. I like them all. Okay. So now we're going to do a few little things here today. I've got some Good Evening New York City things, which I'm going to just sign at random for one of you out there. So this is fun, isn't it? We like this. This is good. Okay, so First Mate Rouge. Hey, Paul. Unfortunately, I'll be at school when this airs live. So what is the good of me talking to you? Good, being at school, good person, learning, applying yourself, very good. But I still hope that you can answer a question of mine. What is your favorite book to read? Well, you know what? I really like Charles Dickens, and my favorite book of his is Nicholas Nickleby. Great book. It's long, but I really love it. It's really good. By the way, if you think I'm just sitting here on my own doing this, it is true. Well, it's almost true. There's only one, two, three people around who actually know how to do this. Look, I'm typing in my answers to you. Look. Oh, no, I'm not. Okay, that's enough of that. So anyway, we've got just a couple of the guys here who set all of this up for us. So that's it. Nicholas Nickleby, favorite book, okay? Next question. You play lots of instruments. If you made an instrument, what would it sound like? From Mixyk. Mixyk. M-C-S-Y-K. It would sound like this. It would consist of one long string, a couple of milk bottles either end, and then you would hit it with a twig. And then if you pull the milk bottles apart, it would sound like this. I mean, let's not get that silly, okay? But anyway, that's what it would sound like. People who've been chatting a lot in the run up to the chat, but worth saying hello to, are, these are some of you who've been really applying yourselves and not at school, I might say. Okay, this is Brian Vall, B-R-I-A-N-V-A-L-L-E-H. And he's Ariel 1852, Macca's Fangirl 183. Hey, Macca's Fangirl with a name like Brian. Brian, are you telling us the whole truth and nothing but? We don't mind. Some of my best friends are people. Are you looking forward to playing Wales from Strawberry Fizz? Yes, indeed, I really am. I love Wales. We often say that Liverpool's the capital of Wales. It's very close. And me and George used to go to Harlech, which is a beautiful town in Wales. It has a beautiful castle. If you're ever going around that way, go and see the castle. And so, yeah, we love Wales, love the Welsh people. My auntie Dillis was Welsh, Dillis Moen, lovely lady, beautiful lady. So, yeah, we're coming to Cardiff to the beautiful Millennium Stadium there and really looking forward to it. I haven't been to Wales in a long time, to play, that is. I have been there to visit, but, yeah, looking forward. Okay, are you coming to Peru? Are you coming to Chile? Are you coming to Argentina? Can you come to Dubai? Do you play any Mexican instruments? Am I coming to Peru? Eventually. Are you coming to Chile? One of these days. Are you coming to Argentina? Could be. One of these days. Can you come to Dubai? Not right at the moment, but love it. Nice sunny place. It's a good idea though, isn't it? One of these days. Combine a little holiday with a little gig. Gig on the beach. Give it up. Okay. Do you play any Mexican instruments? Well, I would class a guitar as very close to a Mexican instrument. I have got a mariachi bass, which I have, and yeah, so I do play a mariachi bass occasionally. I say guitar, Spanish, Mexican, I like this, look at it. Okay, Paul, are you planning to show in Toronto this year? That's from Paul Glee via Facebook. Are you planning a show in Toronto? I think we are, actually. You know what, I'm not exactly sure of the later in the year, but I think we might be going to Toronto. I hope so, because then that will be a nice positive answer. This is from AB2225 via chat. For the summer festivals, might you revive playing Golden Slumbers right through to the end? Yeah, well, might do. You never know. I mean, the truth is that we rehearse up a lot of stuff, and we rehearse a lot of new stuff, and we just see what's best. And we also just see what we've got time for with rehearsing the gigs and this other thing, living life, which also takes up time, as most of you probably know. Anyway, yeah, that's a nice idea. Thank you, AB225. Okay, so, Paul, are you ready to come to Mexico? Am I ready? Am I ready? Yes, I am ready. I am ready. I am primed. I'm honed, and I am ready to come to Mexico. Listen, right now, let's have a little bit of a break. Let's see Man on the Run. Man on the Run, come on, give it up, man. Let's go.
2, 3.
Thank you.
say if I ever get out of here. If we ever get out of here.
Now, I've got a question here, which Band on the Run, by the way, is getting re-released as a remaster this year. And I heard it the other day at Abbey Road. Sounds good, really. Because, you know, there is this thing of why do you do remasters? You know, there was a bit of a controversy over the Beatles things. But when you actually listen to them, I did the other day, the original tape and the new remaster, the clarity is so good. It really sounds good. So I think it's really worth it. Okay, it says, tell us about the up-and-coming remasters. Well, the first, I'm going to sign this little book here for Lloyd MacDonald, who did this question. Here, Lloyd, here's your thing coming up. Lloyd Mac, you shall be. And yeah, well, Band on the Run, is, I say, is going to be the first one. That's for you, coming your way, Lloyd. It's coming a little bit later in the year. And I really like it because what you get is loads of sort of bonuses, and we go into old artwork and all little things that haven't been seen forever. Some nice little things on the DVDs. There's some film of us in Lagos that's not been seen before, and there's some also film from the when we shot the cover of the album with Clive Arrowsmith in Austerley Park, which we use as a backdrop in our live show. That's really worth seeing, and so there's the whole thing there as a little film on the DVD as an extra. Okay, next question. What inspired you to put in new Wing songs in the up-and-coming tour set list? You know, I think, number one, because we like them. We enjoy playing them as a band. And hey guys, band, come on in, the band's all here. So, you know, we were going to just crowd in and groove here. There's Abe coming at you, there's Brian coming at you, there's Rusty, and Mr. Wickens. All right, guys, so we're all here now. The boys are back in town. So there you go, that's for Lloyd. Yeah, no, we like doing the Wings things, and what it is the audience likes it, you know, because we tend to think people are just into the Beatles things. But when you play a Wings thing, there's a lot of this, you know, going on, and a lot of people really digging the whole Wings thing. So that's from Marcia Ward. Thanks, Marcia. Next question. Are you excited to play in Utah for the first time? Are we excited?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah. Utah, here we come. Look out. Watch out. We're coming your way. That's going to be great. Tell you what, also, I want to sign one of these, especially for Stefan, who is at Macablog. Hey, Stefan, what's up? How you doing? Good. It's been very helpful. The guys tell me. Stefan, he is a French person.
Oui.
So, hey, salut, Stefan. Salut, le copain. And here we are, to Stefan. Merci beaucoup, croupier. There you are. Okay, that's for you. So, okay. Would you like to share a cup of tea with me and my mum from Joe Hopkins? Yeah, come on, anytime. We would share a cup of tea.
Yeah, I'm having some right now.
Oh, we are sharing a cup of tea with you right now. All right.
Cheers to you.
Here you go. Cheers, Joe. Hi, Paul. What song are you going to open with on the UK leg of the tour? That would be telling, wouldn't it? There'd be no surprises left. Hey, I'll tell you what. Let me ask you a question here, because you're all writing in. It's going fast and furious. What do you think of the remasters? Good idea, bad idea. By the way, if you think it's a bad idea, we're not going to listen. We don't care.
No,
we actually don't care.
Next
but,
question.
You know,
next answer.
A little bit of, you know, interreaction going there on the old Twitterscope. Anyway, so social network shout-outs. Twitter, MaviMC, C75, shouting out to you. Sandy Blue. Yo, Sandy Blue. And peace and love. All right, anytime. 538, shouting to you. Harum Hoshina. Okay, you got. I hope you got that. The secret language going there. Yaza one more. Shouting out to you. Fabulous Bama. Bama Lama Lama. All right, here we go. Maria Claudia. Joyce Cell. Sounds like a bra to me. Okay, here we go with Spethel Girl. That's a condensation of special Ethel. Spethel Girl. Special Ethel. I remember her.
Yeah.
You remember her? Special Ethel.
Special.
My gosh, she was special. Now, look, I'm only kidding. If you're listening there in America, my friends in America, that's just kidding. That whole idea of Special Ethel is just a joke. But I'm doing a special send out and a shout out to you there, my special friends in America. Okay, so here we go. Thank you, Spethel Girl. Okay, now what we're going to do now is we had a competition, as many of you know, to come with us to Mexico. And we've asked you to put your name in the sombrero. Now, we have a very special friend, Lauren in London, who is just going to choose the winner. So we're going to go live, and we'll now find out from Lauren Laverne, groovy TV host, musician, rock and rolling girl. She's going to pick out the winner. So, Lauren, talk to me, baby.
Hello, Paul. It's Lauren Laverne here. I'm coming to you from London, and it gives me a great honour to check this hat out, pick the very special winner from the sombrero. So let's have a look. Who's it going to be? I'm going to close my eyes, see how good I am. Ooh, it is. The winner is Dora Lawson. Nice work, lady. Dora Lawson has won tickets to see Paul next week in Mexico. That's going to be absolutely splendid. You will get a tour of the backstage area. You can see the sound check and a lovely veggie meal on catering. I've had one of those. Very, very nice. I'm extremely jealous, Dora. Have a great time. But I will be looking forward to seeing Paul on the 27th of June in Hyde Park. So until then, bye, Paul. Thanks very much. Hope the chat's going well. Do you need this hat back or can I have it? It's quite hot out there today.
Yay!
Woo! Woo!
Dora! congratulations, Dora. Thank you, Lorraine. That's beautiful. And Dora, hey, you're coming to Mexico with us. Okay. You did it. You did it. You did it. You know that one? Okay, that's it. Right, so, well, that's going to be very exciting. We're looking forward very much. That's our first coming up gigs. Now we've been rehearsing here. And our next gigs are going to be Mexico. Yeah. Yeah. Me and the boys were heading down Mexico way. And we are looking, you know, last time we played Mexico, it was insane. It was so beautiful. It was very emotional. And this high spot, I remember we were playing every night, and I was singing it. And everyone had cigarette lighters in the audience. And it's 20,000 people. And you could just see going on and off. And I stopped playing, and you could hear them. The sound of little... Remember that?
Yeah.
All the way up.
That was fantastic. And you know what? They didn't miss a beat.
No. Yeah,
some people, it might have just, you know, well, I left them on their own. They just kept rock solid on the tempo there. So that was great. What's your best memory from the US dates you recently played? Oh, man. So many good memories. I think probably playing City Fields, opening the new Shea Stadium there. That was really very special. We had a great time in New York then. And I think for me, you know, probably the best moment was I was innocently saying, you know, how excited I was to be back in Shea Stadium, on the site of Shea Stadium. And I said, however, you know, like we couldn't hear ourselves then for all the girls screaming. And the whole place went, ah! And I must admit, I kind of liked that.
You like that sound?
Yeah, it was kind of nice. You know what I mean? So that was great. How are you going to celebrate the end of the up-and-coming tour?
Ooh,
well, well now. There will be a party. There's no doubt about that. See, what we do normally is after the gig, after any gig, we get onto a bus, all of us guys, and that is it. That is then our moment to relax. We've had to kind of concentrate on the words, getting the songs right, playing good, connecting with the audience. Now suddenly we're off. And so on the last night of the tour, that bus will go to a party.
Mm-hmm. We're rehearsing for that now.
Yes.
We are actually rehearsing.
Rehearsing for the party.
For the party. That's probably the hardest bit of what we do. We did have a little rehearsal last night, actually.
We did, actually.
Yeah, a little rehearsal there. Anyway, listen, one thing we are doing, we're sending out such great greetings to all you lovely people who support us and come to our shows and buy the records and stuff, and have done for millions and gazillions of years. So to all the people all around the world, let's say to our friends in America, yeah, man. Hey. Excellent. To our special friends, New York, Los Angeles, all over America. I want to say to all our friends in Mexico,
Oh yeah,
we're coming. And then Great Britain, Scotland. Was that a British accent?
Hello.
That's rather good, eh?
It's all right, yeah.
How about Scottish? Any good on Scottish?
No.
Very good. Very good. And we're coming to Hampden Park. We are looking forward to that. And then we are coming to Dublin. Oh, very, very, very good. That'll be
in Cardiff. Great, yeah.
As you know, we can't do the accents, but we're trying.
We're
very. But what do we do? Hyde Park. We're looking forward to that. Isle of Wight, Wales, Cardiff, Yakida.
It's going to be fun.
So, you know, it really is. Like, the thing is, see, we enjoy playing together. You know, we've got such nice music to play. He said modestly. That wasn't quite how I intended to say that.
But it's true. Like,
it's true. Yeah, it's true. We have a lot of fun.
Give it up.
And, you know, great band. I love these guys. And we have a great time. So, that's it. No tongues, though.
Oh, come on. No, I'm sorry.
I'm stopping at tongues. Okay, so I've just been given a little notice by Stuart here. Stuart Bell. If you look on our website, this guy has got a column, the hottest column in the universe. Well,
no, it is.
That's what you say.
Not the universe.
Come on,
there
without
are,
a doubt.
There are other columns out there.
That's what he tells us.
Jupiter and Mars. But he does tell us this. So, we are going to a video of Mrs. Vanderbilt, a track which is off Band on the Run. Look out for that remaster, because we certainly are. We're putting everything into it that we hope you're going to like. So, here we go. Mrs. Vanderbilt.
Row. We love you. All right.
Thank you all around the world, all you lovely people sending in the messages. They're really pouring in. You can see if you've got your computer. You must have your computer because you couldn't see me. Okay, I'm working this out as I go along. But listen, we all want to thank you.
Yay!
We want to say we're looking forward to coming and seeing you. Thank you for your support and everything. Thanks for doing all these messages. One little thing here. We have a little bit of news. There's been some rumors, and I think we can just give you a clue here. Think White House. Think playing White House.
That's a little subtle, isn't it?
Just think about it.
Now, the thing is, if there is an announcement mentioning the White House, remember where you heard it first. You heard it here. Right here. Mm-hmm. On the Macatweeter blog. Mm-hmm. So anyway, we're just going to say thank you very much.
Love you.